Oh, it's like inside the... Hold on. What the fuck did you do?
Can't wait till I start wearing three chains.
No, do never wear fucking three chains. Crazy psychopath. Can't wait till I'm wearing 100 chains. Yo, what's up, guys? It's your boy, Full Time Tony. We're back for another episode of Culture is Feud. I'm here with my guy, JC Coates.
What up?
Full disclaimer, I am a part owner of the restaurant we're at today, Smoked Burgers and Barbecue. I'm gonna give a fair and honest review. The food's really fucking good.
Listen, we'll let you guys be the judge of it. We're here for another episode of Culture and Food. We're on the east side of Vegas. We're at Smoked Burgers and Barbecue. We're gonna dive into some ribs, some burgers, some blueberry chicken sliders. Let's go inside and check it out.
Yo guys, I'm Anthony Lee.
And I'm JC Coates.
And we're gonna bring you the best food and drinks
that the foodie culture has to offer.
We are
Culture is Food.
All right, what's up, guys? My name is David Manguel. I'm the executive chef and owner here at Smoked Burgers and Barbecue. We inspired the food from good old smoked meats. We didn't want to compete with any other barbecue restaurants or type of barbecue. Everybody asks, are you Texas? Are you this? It's like our own thing. We wanted to do a Vegas smoke and barbecue. Yeah, so first we're going to give Tony and JC some smoked chicken wings and wanted to do something a little different. So they're marinated overnight, smoked for 2 hours, and they're fried crispy. So everything we do here is fresh chicken. It's just a little bit above and beyond. All right, so all our sauces are gonna be homemade. I have a ketchup base, I have a mustard base. I do my buffalo hot sauce, and then I got a spicy barbecue. So just to complement the wings, everything's served with a cider ranch or blue cheese. Next, we're gonna be doing the world famous blueberry chicken sliders. Buttermilk chicken, soaked overnight, 24 hours. And I do a fresh blueberry jam, fresh sliced jalapenos on a nice little Hawaiian sweet rolls. It was just made by accident, and it's become one of our most signature dishes here at Smoke. Okay, the barbecue porker is recently just added to the menu. It's just to give a nice big portion. So you got an 8 ounce Angus beef patty, fresh pulled pork on top, and one of my mustard based barbecue sauce. Drizzle over the top, topped with crispy bacon, onions, pickles, and a big brioche roll. Another thing, our fries, I mean, I try to make everything different here at Smoke, so even our fries has a little bit of our brisket, kind of a little mesquite flavored kind of fries, but everything's just gonna be a little different here. And then after that, I would give them a full rack, but we're gonna go down to a half a rack of ribs, get it fresh, marinate it 24 hours, it's smoked for 6 hours, then wrapped in tin foil to cook in its own juices. So I'm gonna be serving them half a rack with a couple sides. All right, so after this, we're gonna go back there and start cooking in the kitchen.
Food's ready, we're ready to rock and roll. So first, we got the classic smoked chicken wings. These chicken wings are smoked for up to 6 hours and then flash fried with homemade barbecue sauces. We got, it looks like we got the regular barbecue that's house made by Chef Dave, spice barbecue, also house made by Chef Dave, and the buffalo, all house made by Chef Dave.
Nice.
So I think we should dive in.
Nice, let's dive in.
I'm gonna go with the buffalo.
You're gonna go with the buffalo?
Yeah.
I'll try buffalo.
Yeah, dive in on the buffalo.
This is a nice meaty. Yeah. Mm. This is not your average chicken wing.
No, and let me tell you why. Mm. I used to be a hardcore food truck aficionado with Slater single wing. So these wings are smoked for multiple hours before they get flash fried. And most people don't understand what a smoked wing is because they're all absolutely delicious.
So you put them in the smoker and then you put them in the fryer.
And it gets them beautiful. That's what turns into this beautiful.
It's like a flavor explosion in my mouth.
These are real chicken wings, farm fresh chicken wings. These are big boys. These aren't small guys. Like people are like, oh, you know, what size are your wings? My wings are massive. The wings are huge.
Yeah, spicy barbecue. Woo, that's some good barbecue.
The house made barbecue sauce mixed with sriracha, which is my favorite sauce here.
Give me some more napkins. If you don't get a little on you, you're not doing it right.
Here's the thing. This is not the best place to take your girlfriend on the first date.
Yeah.
This is date 10.
This is when you really love each other.
Yeah, this is when you don't care what you guys look like.
I'm gonna give those wings, those are some of the best wings I've ever had.
Yeah, these are exceptional. And that's, like, honestly, I'm not even lying to you. Today, they're like extra good.
Yeah, I can taste the smoky. The sauce is super unique. It's wing level 1000.
Okay. Next, we have JC's favorite thing on the menu. So for those that don't know, JC was actually the person who got me involved with Smoke. JC was working with them on the trip, brought me in to help with some marketing stuff. And then one thing led to another. We got you know, offered to come here and do it. JC always told me about the world famous blueberry chicken sliders.
Yeah, the fried chicken, blueberry chicken sliders. They're incredible. They're on a, it looks like they're on a one of those Hawaiian rolls, toasted with a little bit of blueberry jam, jalapeno.
And like a house-made sauce.
Don't hurt yourself.
Yeah, don't hurt me.
Cheers.
Cheers. Woo! The flavors of these sliders are crazy.
It's like a 1-2 punch, buttermilk, blueberry.
and then you don't even realize, but the jalapeno at the end is a nice little kick. And look how perfectly cooked that chicken is too. A perfect piece of chicken. And so a lot of people ask us, why don't you guys do like a full sandwich? Well, it's just like, you couldn't get the chicken this crispy and this good in a full breast.
It's almost like chicken and waffles. Very sweet, buttermilk, fried chicken.
Great brunch.
Hawaiian roll. It's a tasty treat.
The barbecue porker. So I actually helped create this menu item.
You helped create this menu item?
Yeah, which me, Chef David, and Ryan, an Angus beef patty with seasoned with our mesquite sauce, a lot of pulled pork. I don't even know the amount of ounces because there's so much on here, and 4 pieces of bacon on a beautiful brioche bun. If you guys saw the 7th Carson, I talked about how buns are so important. This is a nice bun. This is a really good bun. And are the mesquite fries. Those mesquite fries are amazing. There was about double the amount of mesquite fries before we started this episode. JC's had half of them already because they're that good. I don't blame you. I'm here all the time stealing fries.
If you're seasoned fries, these are for you.
If you like seasoned fries, these might be the best seasoned fries on the planet. No bullshit.
Here's
no,
the thing.
No bullshit.
I don't like seasoned fries, but I love these seasoned fries. So it's like, it's a mind-blowing session, you know?
Got it?
Yeah.
Boom.
No. That's not gonna like,
oh, sorry.
What did you do? Sorry. Why did you do that?
I thought I was coming in clutch. I was excited.
Uh-oh, 4 pieces.
The quarter cut.
Quarter cut by Chef Dave. Get a little bit of Chef Dave in there. Say hey, Chef Dave.
Chef Dave. Thank you, Chef.
It's like so good. It's disgusting, it's so good.
All right, I hate you. Ooh, that's the mustard barbecue sauce, huh?
Yeah, this is the mustard barbecue sauce. Once again, house made by Chef Dave.
Very tangy.
And this is a perfectly cooked medium burger. That's what we asked for. We wanted our burger medium. It was perfectly cooked.
The pork is coming through the pork. It's coming through the pork. It's coming through the pork. It's amazing. With a side of bacon.
And we have a cook here. I was like, Anthony, why are you putting so many fucking pickles on the burger? Like, what? Like you're loading that burger up with pickles. And he was like, trust me, had that burger. I was like, wow, I'll never not want pickles on a burger again because, and they're like a good fresh part, you know, to like such a meaty burger.
It's like your, it's the healthy part, the vegetables, right? The vegetables of the, your little cucumber, toss in some vinegar, get some barbecue sauce, some bacon, boom, there you go.
Done. Bingo. Bingo, bingo, thing.
Grand finale. It's the St. Louis ribs. Do you know the difference between a St. Louis rib and a barbecue and a baby back rib?
Yeah, it's the way it's cut, what the part of the cow is from.
It comes from the lower belly. After they remove the stomach, baby back rib will be a lot more curved. The St. Louis rib will be nice and flat. It'll have a bigger bone, creates a little bit more fatty on there, a lot more flavor. Yes, the St. Louis. I prefer the St. Louis over the baby back.
Being from Oklahoma, did you go to St. Louis a lot? Is the St. Louis even near Oklahoma?
Definitely not.
Okay, so first of all, these are fall off the bone ribs.
Woo! That's some good barbecue right there.
When I first ever had ribs, it was at a Chili's. And after I had these ribs, I would vow I would never go to a Chili's ever again to buy ribs. Because these ribs are so fucking good.
You have to taste these ribs.
These might be the best ribs in Vegas.
I know there's a lot of people serious about their barbecue out there. It's a big deal, right? Like, it runs deep. You have to come try this barbecue.
You know.
It's some serious, they put some love into it for sure.
Finger licking good.
I'm getting full.
Uh-oh, JC's in the wall. Uh-oh. Get this guy an energy drink.
I may or may not have had lunch here earlier today.
He may or may not have had the chicken, the pulled chicken pork platter.
Come down to Smoked. This place is amazing.
If you haven't been to Smoked Burgers and Barbecue, one, fuck you for not being a good friend and coming down and trying this restaurant. two, you should come down because it's a great time. There's a putting green, we got ping pong, an awesome patio, great atmosphere. Oh, and by the way, our wall art is super sick. One of our investors slash owners, Alan Anderson, who's a former ex-NBA basketball player, has a really close artist friend named Stephanie, who came by and did all this. And shout out to her. All the art looks fantastic and just great vibes. Bro,
place is amazing. East Side. There's not a lot of barbecue in Vegas. Get down here, try it out. Try the ribs, try the sliders, try the burgers, smoked burgers and barbecue.
And that's it. That's Side. So yeah, so we're gonna go up to Northern Nevada and go check out some of the best spots up in Reno. I'm super excited. You know, for those that don't know, I lived there for 7 years. Kind of made my name there. That's where JC founded me. JC found me in Reno.
I found Tony.
And now I'm really hyped that we get to go down there and try some of the best restaurants that Reno has to offer. So we'll see you guys then. Peace out.
Peace.